Good morning, my viewers. How are you? I've just recently gotten out of bed. This is how I look when I wake up in the morning. So I decided to once again to pour a cup of coffee. And I don't use the coffee pot you see over here behind me. That coffee pot, Fred uses. I use the Keurig. You know, that the one that makes the cup at a time. That's my coffee pot, and I love that fucking thing. Well, super strong, super dark, love it. How you doing today? It's Tuesday. No, it's not. It's fucking Wednesday. I don't know. I just forget the days, until I adjust. Today is Wednesday, January 29th. There we go. So I will remember that now that I have said it out loud. And I'll have to remember it when I go to work. I have to write it a zillion times. Here comes Nola. She's bitching. She wants me to go back to bed. You know, she gets me up to let her out. I feed her. She has to eat. She'll stand in front of her dish and bark. And then she wants me to either go to the couch and lay with her, or she wants me to go back to bed and lay with her. So she's pissy this morning because I'm not doing either one. I'm working on, kicking this fucking seasonal depression shit in the ass. I'm trying to deal with it head on, so I'm doing things like getting up and not laying back down on the couch. So, getting up and doing things. I'm not quite ready to get moving yet this morning. I'm just in a sweatshirt and sweatpants. I will go in and take a shower and get dressed here in a little while. Just like everybody else in America, probably. Anyway, our president did his State of the Union address last night, and, I feel sorry for him because he's up against this Congress that's going to try to stop anything, even if it's a good idea, that he tries to do. And then if they ever get back in office, which I really seriously doubt that America's going to be stupid enough to re-elect a fucking strictly Republican Congress because of what has happened over the past 4 years, or a couple of years, 5 years, whatever. Because Republicans, even if it's a good idea, if it's not their idea, they're not going to approve it. Okay, so I just think Americans have finally gotten the message that this is how Republicans play in the sandbox, and it's not good for us as citizens at all. When they're against things like minimum wage being $10.10 an hour and equal pay for equal work for women, women make up 60% of the workforce now, and yet they still only make 77 cents on the dollar to what men make. I happen to work for a company that does equal pay, and I'm proud of that, and they pay a decent living wage, too, and that's awesome. I asked for less than I'm actually making, and I was very surprised when they offered me quite a bit more than what I actually asked for. So, they were willing to pay for, the skills that I brought to them with 22 years in the construction business. So they're willing to pay a little more for that, and I think that I'll be more valuable to them. You get hired for skills, okay? Remember this. Anybody who ever is out looking for a job or has a job, okay? You get hired for your skills. Right? It's your skills that they want. It's your skills that they need. It's the skills that they see in you that they can teach you that makes people hire you, okay? You get fired for behavior. Your behavior will get you fired. Being good at your skills will never get you fired. Being good at your job will never get you fired. Your behavior at your job will definitely get you fired if it's not good behavior. So, learn how to act in the real world, and learn how to present yourself and present yourself in a good way always, especially in a work environment, because it is your behavior that will get you fired. Skills get you hired, behavior gets you fired. Who said that and it stuck in my head? Jay Leno actually said that the other night in an interview he was having about him finishing his career. He's a pretty interesting guy. I'm a little prejudiced because he has the most fucking incredible car collection in the world that takes up two full friggin' plane hangars at LAX. And it's just, it's a thing of wonder. And people say, what are you going to do after you retire? Yeah, he's going to play in his garages, man. You ought to see them fuckers. They are super sweet. And he has had his hands on every car in there in the restoration of every single car, which is unbelievable. It's his hobby. It's his passion. TV and comedy is his passion for work. He's still going to perform, you know, at the clubs that he performs at. He has performed at for years and years. But, you know, he's not going to be doing the Jay Leno Tonight Show or whatever the hell it is anymore. Jimmy Fallon's gonna take over. You know, it's just the changing of generations, the changing of, you know, what generation is watching that show now. And I think it's good. So anyway, I'm gonna miss Jay a little bit. He pisses me off sometimes, a lot of times. But at the same time, you know, he keeps my interest in if I'm watching late night. So, anyway, yeah. I told you yesterday they did a bunch of comments on the Grammys. I'm going to attach them here. They are from yesterday, okay? A couple of the other artists that I didn't mention that I should have mentioned was that Lord. Oh, my God. 17 years old. What a fucking voice. You know? We're going to hear a lot more from that young lady. We're going to hear a lot more. And I really love her music, and I'm going to be downloading some of that into my iTunes for sure. So I hope you have a fantastic fucking day. And remember, it's Wednesday, January 29th, 2014. Peace. So my comments about the Grammys. I'm not a music buff of any kind, for sure. Okay, 80s music, yes. 70s music, yes. But anything from the 90s forward, man, you know, I'm like the old duffer. You know, I like a lot of it, you know, and as a lot of people know, I do like a lot of rap. I like a lot of the new stuff, a lot of the new pop stuff. But I don't follow who does what. So for me, seeing the Grammys was actually pretty cool because I got to see the people who did the songs, you know? Oh. But Macklemore and Ryan Lewis killed it, obviously, and so did the fucking robots, Daft Punk, which I don't get. Other than that song, Get Lucky, what did they do? I don't get it. I guess they must have, like, done a lot, because they got a lot of fucking Grammys, you know? And the first time I ever heard of them was on Grammy night. Of course, I had heard the song Get Lucky before, you know, on the radio and shit, but I didn't know it was a couple of robot guys that didn't want anybody to know their identities or whatever, or didn't want anybody to see what they look like today. I saw a picture of them from 20 years ago yesterday, you know. So either they've lost all their hair, or they've been in massive car accidents and they wear these helmets so that you can't see. Or whatever, you know. Actually, what they say is they want it to be about the music and not about what they look like, which I think is actually kind of neat in a way. But regardless, I think they should have said something, you know. You know, I don't know. It's kind of a weird, I just thought it was kind of weird to see a couple of robots keep getting on the stage in various different robot costumes. And where do they get all the time to go and change into these different costumes, too? You know? I mean, the Grammys must take 12 or 15 hours to film. You know, with all the set changes and all this stuff. I don't know. I'm not up on Grammy lore on how it's done, on when it's started, on when it's actually filmed. There's a lot of controversy, I guess. From what I hear in the LGBT community out there about Macklemore's rendition of Same Love and the 33 marriages, gay and straight, that took place with Queen Latifah officiating. And there's, you know, I hear comments about people complaining that a straight man spoke up, you know, and did this, and that they did this at the Grammys, and you know, I don't understand. You know, we need our straight allies. And I commend Ryan Lewis and Macklemore for doing this performance. And Madonna, I think, thought she looked like she was wicked high and gonna fall the fuck over with that cane when she came out. She didn't sound anything like herself. Am I wrong? Did anybody else see that? Okay, she did not sound like herself. She looked really fucked up. She looked like she was gonna fall on her face and like she didn't even know where she was. That's just my opinion. But regardless, it was still a beautiful performance. Mary Lambert doing that song, which She Keeps Me Warm is an excellent song. I love that song. Was a bonus. It was Mary Lambert being an out lesbian. I thought that was a bonus. I thought it was kind of neat, the whole 33 marriages thing. And I think, you know, anything that we can do to promote equality in this country in any way, shape, or form, regardless of sex, race, gender, gender presentation, religion, any of that stuff is good, you know. And I don't care who wants to do it, who wants to help, you know, to get the message out that we're all the same. It's same love, like the song goes, same love. So, I thought that was great. My favorite performance of the Grammys was Pink, okay? Now, people will probably say it was Beyonce, but no. When Jay-Z got on the stage with Beyonce, Mainelybutch lost interest, okay? But Pink, man. That woman is in some fucking incredible shape. She did that shit with no net, you know, and that was pretty fucking incredible. She showed incredible body strength to be able to sing while she was. Doing that? I don't know. Is that where this, what do you call it, when they put the song, I don't know, dubbing it or whatever, you know, could it have been, or was it a live performance? I would really like to know the answer to that, because her singing while she's spinning and whipping through the air and upside down and all that stuff is pretty fucking skillful. And that, my friends, is what I had to say basically about the Grammys. I did again forget to mention Lorde. She did a great job. Carole King and Sarah Bareilles, that was an unbelievable performance that they did. You know, I just thought the whole thing was actually really well done. I did not appreciate Jay-Z adding the line about just eat the cake, in the reference to all of the years that Tina Turner was abused. You know, it comes from the movie about it, and it wasn't in very good taste, in my opinion. Okay, so I did enjoy Beyonce's performance now, okay, but I don't know, Jay-Z could have not come on stage and I wouldn't have given a shit less. So I had a good time watching it. Noel had a good time watching it. We forgot popcorn, so we had pretzels. I hope you had a good time. Let me know what you thought of the Grammys. Peace.